We got enough talkers, we need the doers in Washington. Where are the jobs going to come from? Three places. Small business, manufacturing. We lost manufacturing jobs every year. We gained manufacturing jobs in 6 of the 8 years I was president, and we can gain them every year from now on for a good long time if we do it right. And thirdly, because unemployment in construction is 25%, from changing the way we produce and consume energy, if we made every school, every college, every university building, every state, county, and local building, every big hospital more energy efficient, it would save billions of dollars in taxpayer money and put millions of people to work. That's where we're going to get the job. Those three places. Now, how do we get the workers? Well, first of all, we're going to get them from the people that are ready. Start with construction. You got 25% unemployment, you can't build houses. You got to retrofit the buildings. You got to make them more efficient in an organized way. They're working on that in Washington. Secondly, we ought to look at a little part of the stimulus that he voted for that's kept 200,000 Americans working and is said to be the main reason Germany's doing better than anybody else now coming out of this. They pay companies to keep people working in hard times instead of waiting until they're laid off and paying them unemployment. They pay less to keep people on the job. There's a little of that in the stimulus, and every state, including a lot of states with Republican governors, has said this is a very good thing. We need to keep people on the job. Third, this is where all of you come in. In the last 8 years, now 9, almost 10 years, we went from first in the world to 12th in the percentage of our young people with college educations. And we cut back on training in sophisticated mechanical and other kinds of work. So listen to this. It is true that for some job openings, we have 1,500 applications. The other day, we have two residencies still open in Arkansas. I was just down there for doctors. There were 334 applications for those two vacancies from all over America. But posted jobs, that is jobs that could be filled tomorrow, are being filled at only half the rate they were being filled in the last recession. Why? Because there's not a good skills match. We got to get back in the business of training people to do the jobs that are open so they can get these good paying jobs and pay them. And all of you have to help. If you need that training, you got to go get it if they provide it. But don't tell me if you can't do this. We can do it. We can come back even better than before. Now, that's a better program than just going back to what got us in the mess in the first place. Don't regulate the economy no matter what. Cut taxes no matter what. Pretend like it's all free. Borrow the money from China. Who cares if we create jobs? I don't think that's a very good strategy. We tried that now. It's not like we don't know how it works. You know that old saying, when you get in the hole, the first thing you're supposed to do is to quit digging? We have quit digging. We haven't built our way out of that hole as fast as anybody wanted, but it was a very deep hole.
Very deep.
If you choose the alternative, what they're going to do is show up, every one of them, when they get sworn into Congress, they'll have one hand on the Bible, and with the other hand, they'll be holding a shovel. They want to dig again. It's not a good idea. You know what works. I honestly believe this country's best days can still be ahead, but you know, we get into the future by changing, by thinking, by doing. So if people are just mad and they want to hear somebody vent, we're in trouble. If people say, oh, I'm too disillusioned to go vote, they might as well be voting for the other side. And if people say, by the way, they're concerned about government spending, just say that so far President Obama and the Congress, they're pikers compared to what went on before. They managed to double the debt of the country while we had economic growth. He appointed a bipartisan commission to balance the budget, chaired by one of the co-chairs, was Erskine Bowles, my former chief of staff, who's just retired as president of the University of North Carolina. It's not like we don't care about 90% of the work was done by a Democratic Congress in 1993. We know this is important, but you've got to do this in the right order. And my view is this. Again, I know something about this economic situation. A year and a half just wasn't enough time to get us out of the hole we were in. So I want you to stick with us. Give us two more years. Two more years, you have another election. You think we failed, you can throw us all out. But for goodness sakes, don't go back to the shovel brigade. We have stopped digging. We don't need to start digging again. So, that's what I want you to say to other people. I'm telling you, I met Kendrick Meek when he was a very young man. We've had a lot of interesting times together. He's told some of them in this election. I've seen him grow as a person and as a public servant. I saw him come to terms with being a congressman. I saw him sit there and look at other people and look at what was being done and figure out how to get things done. I saw him spend two or three or four times as much time doing as he did talking. And that's what America needs. That's what Florida needs. In the world. And when I leave you, I'm going down to Haiti to spend another 2 days there working on the rebuilding. Kendrick was one of the leaders in passing a bill in Congress for us to buy more products from Haiti instead of from Asia, and I believe it will lead to $300 million in investment there. This guy's my friend, and I do love him, and I guess you can discount everything I say, but I'm telling you, you look at my eyes, I believe everything I've told you today. He will be a great senator, and he can't get there.